I have some breaking news. Let's end with the breaking news instead of music today, because a new report has suggested that a peculiar and potentially dangerous situation unfolded at AEW events in Long Island when a fan posed as a wrestler and made it to the locker room.
Are you serious?
This is on right now. ITR Inside the Ropes is the company over there in England, ITRWrestling.com. I don't know if they credit another. Oh, Fightful Select is reporting this, and they are re-reporting it. An incident took place backstage. The report states that the building security at UBS Arena let a fan who was posing as an extra backstage. A job guy is basically what he was apparently masquerading as. The report states that building security let him in. The fan then took the bold step of entering the inner sanctum of the professional wrestler, the locker room, where he unwittingly took up residence in Dax Harwood's chair. The fan was promptly told to move before relocating to Blade's chair. Remember Blade of the Butcher and Blade fame. It is reported that questions were soon asked of the fan as suspicions were aroused as he was putting on what was described as Jeff Hardy-style armband. The fan was then asked who trained him before naming Hardy as his wrestling coach, which came as a surprise to the wrestlers present, as Jeff Hardy does not train wrestlers. The fan is then reported to have given the wrong name when asked who booked him as an extra. And it was at this point that MJF and Dax Harwood seemingly decided enough was enough and threw him out. They are said to have taken him to someone who was able to confirm that the same fan had been kicked out of an AEW show in Boston in October.
In Boston? Wow.
So this has happened before, where some fucking schlub would just walk in the back, tell security he's a wrestler, be carrying a wrestling bag or whatever, and try to do this. But now I guess it's more difficult than ever to determine who the wrestlers are from who the fans are by looks alone, since they all look the same. And in some cases, the fans look a little tougher than the wrestlers these days. But apparently, thankfully, Dax and MJF, who have wits about them and know what the fuck they're doing, were able to figure out this. No, hold on, this guy. But yeah, he just walks in, carried a bag, sits down, starts putting on his Jeff Hardy armbands in the AEW locker room. Hey, everybody gets an opportunity. Everybody can play. He took it seriously. Do you know not only how difficult it would have been for anybody to do that in the territory days, almost impossible, but what would they would have had a more exciting exit from the locker room than being taken to somebody who could tell that they were full of shit and asked to leave. I'll say that. I was back in the back in the Louisville Gardens in 1978 when Don Fargo had gotten there late. It was his first week back in the territory and he was late. He was riding by himself and he's beating on the back door of the gardens. The fucking Andy Frayne usher wouldn't let Don Fargo in. And he said, look at me. And he had a fucking inch and a half long gig mark across his cheek and a fucking black eye. And he said, look at me. You think I'm not a fucking wrestler? And I heard it and had to go and vouch for Don Fargo to get in the fucking building. If anybody made it past security and got in the locker room instantly, the boys would have known it was bullshit, even if it was job guys at a TV taping. You knew most everybody, or the job guys that came knew everybody, and that guy would have got the teetotal shit kicked out of him. But now I guess you can't tell the players without a program, Brian.
Well, let's just be happy that for once there was a fan incident and no one was attacked or anything happened. It was just someone who wanted to pretend he was looking for work.
No, he wanted to pretend he had work. And that's what I'm upset about. Nobody was attacked.
That was the first sign that someone realized something was wrong. They said, yeah, like, we need more extras.
Yeah. Well, I think somebody ought to dotted his I and crossed his T before they let him out. But that's just me. Anyway.